PXX70 Video 2 Audio. Audio set is the third menu represented by an eighth note. Here we will make adjustments for audio recording and format. The volume item is meant to adjust the volume in your headphone. The phone jack is on the left side of the camera below the LCD panel. Return to the audio set menu and move down to AVCHD audio format. Move to the right and choose between Linear PCM or Dolby Digital. Linear PCM, pulse code modulation, is uncompressed, lossless audio. Dolby Digital is compressed. I would recommend LPCM. Make your selection and press the menu button to exit. Return to the audio set, move down to Record Level Mode. Select it and move to the right to choose between normal, high, or manual. This sets the recording level for the internal mic. If you choose manual, move down to manual record level and move the cursor left or right to select a level between 1 and 31. I would recommend choosing normal. The next item in the audio set is internal mic wind. This is essential if you're recording outdoors with an internal mic to reduce the wind noise. Press the joystick, move to the right, and toggle off and on. Make your selection and press the menu button to exit. Next, Mic Select gives a choice between internal mic, MI, multi-interface shoe mic, or stereo mic. Internal mic is built in and controlled by the menu items. Two XLR inputs allow for external mics to be attached. They are controlled by the switches on the handle. First, choose the type of device you plan to attach before connecting. Line if you are receiving a signal from a soundboard. Mic for regular dynamic mic. Mic plus 48 volts for a mic that requires phantom power. Using a mic that is not compatible with 48 volts may damage the mic. If you are not connecting a mic, leave it in the line position to prevent unwanted noise. Record channel select. Choose the channels you have microphones plugged into. Are you using input 1 or input 1 and 2? Choose attenuation 0 dB, 10 dB, or 20 dB based on the noise level of your environment. Balance attenuation with the audio level dial to get a strong signal that is not distorting. On the far right are switches to turn on low-cut filters for input 1 and 2. Use these when you are working outside or in a noisy environment. Back in the audio menu, stereo mic allows the connection of a mic through the mini jack on the right side of the camera near the lens. This works well with the Rode Go Wireless mic available in the sign-up. Attenuation controls on the mic are your only option for manual controlling the input when using the mini jack. The next menu item is audio output timing. In the live selection, audio is output without any delay. In the lip sync connection, audio is synchronized with the video before output. Use this if you are using the HDMI jack to record to an external device. Be sure to watch your audio meters and listen with headphones as you record. Many people have returned to the edit suite with good video and no audio because the previous user had different settings for audio.